Okay, so the students are just bowing in. They've been led by our second degree black belt instructor, Richard, at the front there. And they're going to show you some breathing exercises now. Running around is our mascot, that's Kuk Sool Ted. Say hello to him when he comes around. And if you want to come and see us after the demonstration, you can come and meet Kuk Sool Ted at our stand, which is located over near the beer tent, actually. So what they're showing you now are internal energy gathering techniques.
Take about 4 years to attain your first degree black belt.
But you can go on train your whole life, because there's a syllabus up to 8th degree black belt, which will take about 50 years from start to finish. Okay, so he's going to show you a falling demonstration now. It's a bit warm, so I think Liam in the middle just needs that to put his head on. He's going to stand on his head the whole time. So falling is a very important part of any self-defense system. Sometimes it's not just getting pushed or thrown that causes the injury, it's falling badly. So learning to fall is extremely important. They showed you a back fall, now they're showing you a side fall. And this is a front break fall. And you'll see the importance of falling a bit later on when we start doing self-defense techniques. And the fact you need to fall out of many of the techniques. So we're doing an offer today. Anybody that's interested can come along and have a free intro class with absolutely no commitment whatsoever. Then if anybody wants to go ahead and sign up, we are offering half price membership and half price first month's training for anyone who comes to us as a result of today. So even if you're interested, you just want to come and have a Tommy Works to defend yourself against it. And it's all about technique. It's really not about strength, power. It's about getting the technique. Martial arts training for the young is a fantastically valuable thing to do, because we do teach self-respect, respect for others, we work on self-confidence, teamwork, all that kind of good stuff that we all...
Demonstrating a brown black belt form, star form. Before you learn the star form, you learn 15 techniques, standing still star techniques, and then you'll learn 3 moving techniques, which are all in this form itself. It requires a lot of concentration, a lot of skill, a lot of training to be able to use a staff in that manner. Well done, sir. Everybody give him a round of applause.
Balance, coordination. Memory. Thank you. So you'll see various attacks with these techniques, kicking, punching type attack and defense. But also I think the first degree black belts over there, James and James, are showing some clothing grabs. So he's been grabbed from behind, his wrists have been grabbed, and then he's applying a self-defense technique. If anybody doubts any of the stuff, it happens sometimes when you're watching it, and you want to come and say, how did that work? Please come and see us. And we'll teach you, we'll show you, we can teach you. Anyone that wants to come and just learn something real fast today, come over, we'll show you something in 5 minutes you can take away, practice on your family and friends. The Buddhist monks used to carry the staffs when they would walk around. And occasionally they'd get attacked.
CJ, Eva.
Buddhists don't believe in killing anything.
You're on the after this, right?
So they would learn to defend themselves with sticks and learn martial, warlike type techniques purely to defend themselves when they travelled around. So a Buddhist monk would never have carried a sharp blade weapon, for instance. They come from the royal court type traditions. The julbong in Korean, or nunchaku as most people call it, it's taught at, it's also taught, these are practice ones, so they're foam, because as you can see, they take a lot of practice, but they're a farming implement for most people know about those, because of Bruce Lee making them famous. So they were showing some orientation techniques, James, practicing on Chris. And over here we have CJ and Eva who are sisters, and the black belt they're throwing around is their brother. It's CJ's birthday today, so give her an extra big round of applause, please. Hey! Still came here to show you this stuff. The bowing that you see us do is purely a mark of respect for each other and what we're doing. Again, some people think the bowing has something to do with an Eastern type religion. It really does not. Okay, so the adults or the instructors here are going to demonstrate all of the under black belt forms at once, or one each. So there's a white belt form, a yellow belt form, a blue belt form, a red belt form, a brown belt form, a black brown belt form. So by the time you get to brown belt, you know all these five cones take you about 15 minutes to run through them, one each, if you're doing them. You do that four times, you've had quite a workout. It is hard work in this heat as well. Well done, everyone.
By the time we get to second degree, which is forms learnt, you've learned all the forms you've just seen, plus another one. This requires a lot of balance, concentration, a lot of jump kicks, a lot of down and upward motion. It requires very strong legs.
Onto a fully live blade.